So now that the coop's mucked out, it's on to the next problem. And this is the problem right here. I'm in it. This is the main chicken run. All the way to the back, it's probably 20 feet, 25 feet. It's about 3 feet wide. And this is a problem that's crept up recently. I didn't think this would be a problem when I built this, but recently it has been a problem. Here's the issue. And you can see it right here, this rutting. The chickens are digging out along the edges. Both of the edges of this run are severely eroded down from the action of the chickens digging in them. Part of the problem is because where I'm sitting in here, this is a slope. The lowest part is where the camera is. The highest part is at the end, and it's a pretty good slope. There might be 5 feet of difference over this 20 feet, at least. So I can't just add mulch in here because any mulch I put in the top is going to end up right there, right where the camera is, where you're sitting. The chickens will very quickly start scratching and down it will go with gravity down the slope. So I gotta figure out a way to keep the mulch up and stop it from going downhill. So for that, here's the plan. And it's based on what I've seen on a lot of trails, hiking trails. I'm gonna take a series of boards. This is just an example. I'm gonna use like 4x4s or round posts, big round posts, big stuff. And I'm gonna put it across the whole run just like this and create a series of headers every 4 or 5 feet, something like that. And then stake these to the ground using pieces of rebar or old scrap metal that I have. A series of these, like a ladder laying on the ground all the way to the top of the run. My thought is that will stop a lot of this material from migrating down that away to you via gravity. Each header is going to catch stuff and at least hold some back or slow the descent of mulch, which I'm gonna put back here down to the bottom. So I'm hoping this is gonna work. What I have to do is cut a series of ladder rungs to go all the way up this, and then I have to haul all the mulch in, and this is not gonna be the funnest of jobs to do because it's a tight space, as you can see. I'm gonna have to bend over in here. I'm gonna have to haul the mulch in totes. I'm 6 feet, 200 pounds. It's not the easiest space to work on. I'm sitting in chicken manure right now, so I'm gonna be covered in it by the end of it. But I gotta fix this problem because one of the issues that's also came up with this erosion is I'm now kind of vulnerable to predators because the bottom of the fence used to be buried probably 3 to 4 inches deep and it is now exposed. So I've actually seen squirrels duck right under this and go out the other side. So I need to build this up. So I'm hoping this header method is gonna work. Now it's time to make it happen. The joy of working in tight quarters with manure. You get it on your arms. Gotta love it. So this is the concept that I'm going for, having the 4x4 stretched across the row. I didn't even have to cut this. I actually found three of them I didn't even have to cut. I just found spots in the fence where they could press tight, and I tried to put them on the uphill side of the posts so the posts are retaining them from going down, but I'm also going to tack them in by just putting some metal stakes on either side to hold them in place. I don't know if this is gonna work, but I think that's at least enough of a barrier to hold some of that mulch in place and hopefully allow me over time to start building this run back up because it's probably lost 3 inches over time. And it's hard to believe that the surface of this run used to be probably higher than that board in there. So we'll see how it works. Hopefully that works. So remember that mulch I got from the tree trimmers? Here it is. And I've strategically been saving part of it. The part that's not the wood chips, which I used to cover certain areas and pathways. The part that I've been saving is this real coarse, almost stringy material. I've been saving it for this project right here because it's stringy and I think it's gonna wanna mat and stick together versus roll like loose little pieces, cobbles, marbles would wanna roll. I think I'll be able to put this down and from the chickens walking on it, it's just gonna wanna press itself into like a felt and hold itself in between these headers that I'm putting in. And pollen itself takes a long time to break down. It's slow to break down. So my other thought of putting these pollen fronds in there is that it's gonna be in there for a while, but we'll see how it lasts. I'm getting smart though this time because I've installed those three headers now and I'm gonna put mulch in there and go ahead and test it before I go and do the whole run and realize this idea sucks or this idea doesn't work. So I'm just gonna put it in the areas that I've already established first to see how I like it, to see if it looks like it's gonna be possible, and to see how fun it's gonna be getting all that mulch in there through that tiny hole via this tote. Not the most fun thing. All right, load one. There, my thought is, now, this is gonna mat together and just hold in place via itself and via these headers. It's soft enough for the chickens to walk on. I don't think they're gonna really like scratching into this too long. And I think this is gonna last a long time. This is not the Pacific Northwest. We're pretty dry here. Stuff takes a long time to break down. So I think this may be the solution. And this is about how far one tote got me. So I probably have 10 totes, which isn't as bad as I thought. Right now, I'm liking the idea. What'll be interesting is to see how much they scratch and tear this up. Now that I've cleaned out the underside of the coop, which is nice because it's pretty much bare soil under there right now, I'll be able to tell how much of this is actually migrating downward where I wouldn't have been able to before. All right, I filled in these two areas. I think it's gonna work. I like it. It's at least gonna work for now. Whether this is the long-term plan or not, I don't know. But I'm liking the matting effect. The headers, I think, are gonna do a good job. If anything, this will just stop the erosion process. It might not build it back up, or it might take slowly to build it back up as this stuff breaks down, but what it's gonna do is stop the erosion process by keeping those little chicken claws off the bare soil, because when it does rain here in the winter, this thing turns into a mud pit, and a lot of that soil is going down the slope. So I'm hoping this will provide enough of a carpet to stop that from happening. So there we have it, it is done. I have carpeted my chicken run. This is essentially just deep bedding on a slope, that's all it is. I've piled up 3 to 5 inches in various places of palm shreddings and some wood chips. I think the palm is gonna work out really good because it's got the fronds, which will mat down like a felt. And also parts of the palm, it almost seems like a coir. I know it's not coir, but when they grind up palm, it kind of looks like coir. My ultimate hope here is as they continue to walk on it, they pack it all down and it stays in place. Maybe I'll come back later, add more on top of it, or I can fine top it with some finer bedding, maybe even some wood shavings like I would just put in the coop now that I have the base here and these headers to do it. But it's these headers, I think, that are really going to make the difference from keeping all this stuff from just sliding down that away. But this is it. I am dirty. I'm dusty. I'm covered in manure, my knees are killing me, and I'm ready to get out of this run. So that's all for this one. Thanks for watching. Until next time, be nice, be thankful, and do the work.